Tonight, the results are in.
Paleo crusader Pete Evans and his backer Channel 7 are in an awfully sour pickle again.
I thought it was quite one-sided, almost like an advertorial.
The celebrity chef's been slammed yet again for spruiking what some say are irresponsible diet trends on the network's investigative journalism program Sunday night.
Investigatory journalist.
It all started last week when this social experiment slash ratings grab slash what angry health experts are now calling a shameless exercise in self-promotion went to air.
Probably wouldn't feed any of this sort of cereal to my dog.
A lot of what Pete Evans promotes is just not balanced. If we were all paleo, we'd all be dead at 40.
Last week, Channel 7 sent veteran reporter Mike Willacy to road test Evans' so-called miracle paleo diet.
I want an independent assessment of where I'm at now and where I'm at in 10 weeks' time.
But both during and after the broadcast, critics like the Dietitians Association of Australia put the program on the chopping board, questioning its credibility and sources. The Weekly's Charlie Pickering summed it up in a nutshell.
The spokespaleo for Channel 7's dietary road test was Pete Evans, who is also the host of 7's hit My Kitchen Rules. Thankfully, paleo doesn't say anything about cutting down on conflicts of interest.
Although the special paleo program was served up as a one-off episode following the backlash, last night Channel 7 pulled out a surprise second course, or part two of the story, this time bringing in more rigorous research from more independent experts.
The people who were interviewed all had an affiliation with Channel 7.
Namely, this guy, dietitian Matt O'Neill from The Morning Show, also on Channel 7.
I know he's a fantastic chef, but he's not a dietitian.
Sunday night's executive producer, Steve Taylor, has defended the segment in a statement, saying that it was never meant to be a piece of hard-hitting investigative journalism, but instead more of a road test, with the remaining parts still to air.
Just so long as you can make a name for yourself as an investigatory journalist.
For those like me that have avoided the almighty PR machine behind all this paleo palaver, it's based on cutting out processed food and eating only the food of cavemen. Basically meat and bone broth.
Promoting fad diets in the media is perpetuating very strict eating styles, which are unnecessary, creating disordered eating.
So is this in fact rigorous journalism or just a free kick at ratings, preying on diet fad hungry viewers? I'll leave that to you and Pete Evans' book sales to decide. In the meantime, stay tuned for Sunday night's next foray into investigative journalism.
Vaccinations. Should we really be jabbing our kids? Prominent anti-vaxxer and Sydney Morning Herald cartoonist Lunig will be rigorously road testing for answers. That's next week on Sunday Night.